Hey, good morning, guys. So welcome to day four of our third week as our journey has been going with the Psalms devotional. And we're super excited because today we're going to be talking about something that David does, another great habit to form. And it's the idea of reminding ourselves every single day what God has done for us, how God has taken us from one step to another to another. And so let's just jump on in. We're going to be in Psalm chapter 4, verses 6 through 7. David writes, "Many are asking, who can show us any good? Let the light of your face shine upon us, O Lord. You have filled my heart with great joy, than when the grain and new wine abound." So this is something that's amazing. You know, David is sitting there and people are questioning him and they are saying, where is the good? Maybe the question is, where is the good in the world right now, right? And David's sitting there and he knows, right? He knows that it's God. He knows that all goodness is coming from God. And he says, Lord, just shine down upon us. Let your face shine upon us so that we can see your good. And you know, the thing is that he writes about how that he has more joy than when their grain and the wine abounds, right? They have more. Basically what he's saying is, you know, he could have everything he needs, the food, the wine, the drink, he could have power, he could have whatever he can have in the world is at his hands, and yet nothing gives him more joy than being in the presence of God. And so just my encouragement to you is, maybe you're struggling and you're battling, you feel like, and you know that you have everything. In a sense, you feel like, you know, you've got the house, the cars, the spouse, the financial stability, you know, you've got a good job, you're able to take, you know, two vacations with your family, you know, you don't have really any enemies, but you're struggling and you're saying, man, like, where is the good? I have it in the world's perspective, but where is the good? My encouragement would be, as it's always going to be, is to get along with Jesus. You know, I always try to encourage you, and I'll encourage you tomorrow on Friday, is to get alone with Jesus. Spend time and Saturday and Sunday, and every day if you can, to just get into your room or just be in your car, turn off your music, close your door in your room, and just be alone with Jesus. And the reality, guys, is that everything that we experience, whether it's spouse, our spouse, it's cars, it's material possessions, it's finances, it's jobs, it's vacations, it's friendships, they're all amazing gifts from God. Don't ever forget that. But the truth is that what is greater than the gift is the gift giver and being with him. And so my encouragement is, if you're struggling, you have it all, just spend time with Jesus. You know, 5 minutes with him changes everything, I promise you. When you could sit there and take a few deep breaths and see yourself, as I said a couple weeks ago, the way that I try to meditate or pray is I close my eyes, because that helps relieve, take away some distraction. I close my eyes and I think about one of the most peaceful places I've ever been in my entire life, where I could just feel peace. You know, you weren't bothered by the news or by the world or by your job, by social media. You were just at peace. And when you're there, see Jesus walking up and sitting alongside with you, and just spend time with him. Honestly, I try to do it every single day, and it's when I don't that I don't feel as fulfilled. And it's not because I don't have one thing or another, it's just the fact that there were times in my life where I was spending hours with Jesus and a day, and my job kind of had that, you know, gave me the capability to do that. And that's not really like that right now. It's not. And I miss it. But when you've tasted the greatest joys that you can ever taste, and then you taste anything else, it just doesn't compare. And so I believe that as a Christian, that when you first came to know Jesus, when you first became overwhelmed by the Holy Spirit and just by the beauty of Jesus and the love of God, that you tasted that. And if you're still yearning for it, it's probably because you haven't been with him in some time. If you have, maybe it was just like I experienced, it was just a distracted time. My encouragement is to just go back, keep going back, and don't give up. You know, I love, there's this one very successful person in this world. He talks about the idea that 99% of people fail and then they give up. But the ones who succeed, it's that 1% that fails and fails and fails and fails and never gives up, but just keeps pressing forward. I promise you guys, that is true in life, it's true in work, it's true in your family, that you just keep pouring into people and loving people and keep pressing forward. But even more is it the most overwhelming joys when we come to Jesus. And even if we get distracted, you try to spend 10 minutes here, you actually end up spending only 1 moment or 1 minute of focused time with Him, that you just keep trying, and then that 1 minute will turn to 2 and 3 and 5 and then 10 minutes, and then you can spend more time. And I promise you guys that, you know, we are never going to be filled with more joy than when we are with Jesus. Jesus says, I am the vine and you are the branches. You know, if you know anything about vines and branches, the branches are receiving all their sustenance and the nourishment from the vine. So the more we want to be nourished, the more time we need to spend with Jesus. So I just want to encourage you guys with that. You know, if you're listening to this on the way to work, turn off your radio, turn off your iPhone, whatever you're listening on, and just be still and listen and know that He will speak to you. Just, even if you don't feel it, just acknowledge His presence. He is always with you. He loves you. He is for you. And I love you. And I hope you guys have an amazing day. As always, subscribe below, like, comment, whatever you guys would like to do. Turn on the alert, of course, so that we post a video every single weekday that you will see it and receive it. So, love you guys. Have a great day. We'll see you tomorrow. Friday's here. Love you guys.